What's up guys, this is Chairman Studios here with a new series of how-to videos, and today we will be covering lots of stuff, how to make simple redstone machines, portals, and how to survive out in the wilderness during your spawn. So I'm here in Super Flat, and guess what, I spawned in an NPC village, it's kinda cool. So I'm over here, and right now I'm gonna be working on another portal. So whenever you're in survival and you wanna find another portal, you can't find it. You gotta make it. So, what you'll need is, in order to get the obsidian, you'll need water. You need to find a lava source. Or you can get a lava bucket, make an unlimited lava source, and just mix it up, and do it that way. So I'm gonna show you two ways to make it today. And you will need, well, if you want to do one way, you need a diamond pickaxe, of course, to mine it. But today I'm just showing you how to make it, and I'll show you the tools and survival. You will need flint and steel. You only need one. You will need, think about, just get 12 obsidian, get a water bucket, and a water source, and a lava bucket, and a lava source. And you will need at least some dirt, or anything, any other block. So, here's the first way to make it. Just take the obsidian, put it four across on the bottom, put it four high, wait, no, five high, one, two, three, four, there, put it across, and that's how you make it one way. See, it just makes it automatically. Now here's another way, it's more difficult, but you do not need, you do not need a diamond pickaxe to do this way, and a lot of people recommend this. So what you will need is, you'll need to have kind of like a frame for the floor on the bottom. And you just make the frame. And put it in lava. Oh, well, it's three, I'm sorry. Alright, then you will need to put water going across the top. Spread it out, and the water's supposed to hit that first. And see, it makes obsidian. So there, you got your bottom part. Then you will need to build the frame going up. Sorry about my sound quality, guys. I'm trying to work on it. Get built up. Pour in lava. Alright. Make the second layer. And then you put that there. You got your next two layers. Then you're gonna do your top layer first. Actually, you'll do this, and you'll put the water going across. And there will be a little flooding mishap. So don't put it nowhere where redstone would be. Cause it just burns. Whoa! Not cool. Not cool at all. Sorry. And you will put that down there, just destroying that, and you destroy the frame you built around it, and destroy the frame around it again, and there you go, you have one layer. So, look at that, you already have that, and you basically do that the rest of the way around, just build the frame up, let the water hit it. So, I'm just going to go to fast forward and build the rest of that thing for you, since you guys got a good idea of how to make it like that. And there you go. So, both come out with the same outcome. Now that we've covered nether portals, now we're going to have to go to simple. Now we go to the simple redstone. And I'm going to show you how to wire pistons and repeaters and TNT. Alright, so simple TNT wiring is pretty simple. If you want to get complicated with it, that's totally fine with me. It just starts with the basics with redstone wire. Now, redstone only goes up to 9 spaces without needing any assistance. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, without any assistance from redstone tools. See? Because look, I can light this up right now. See? But otherwise, if I went 10, sorry, I guess I'll just enter that. So, now I'll show you what to do with needles. Powered rail. You also need a detector rail, and you would also need a regular rail. Now the detector rails, you put one near every single one, every single redstone. It automatically fixes it. Then you will need powered rail, powered rail, powered rail, powered rail, powered rail, powered rail, powered rail. And you just keep doing that around there. Power rail, power rail, power rail, power rail, power rail, power rail, and power rail, power rail, power rail, power rail, power rail, power rail, and power rail. And it's kind of like a corner power. Power rail, power rail, power rail, power rail, power rail, and regular rail. So, and you will put a piston to every single one of those. You get a cart to go, and the detector rail automatically sets off and repairs. Similar to the mine cart. Totally messed up. Alright. We'll get it going. There we go. See how it powers it? Because of the detector rails. Now you put your repeaters there.
I just made myself a little revolving lighthouse. So, double trick for today is an extra. I'm not trying to change those to sticky pistons. Sorry guys. Just kind of figuring this out on my own too. So there you go, I made a little revolving lighthouse. So there you go, redstone lesson for today. Hope you guys liked it. Very cool. And I'm gonna write it, actually. So there we go, I'm going around the revolving lighthouse. And my next video will be pretty cool. I'm not gonna tell you what it is. So thank you for watching my video, and I hope this helped you and a lot of my friends a lot. Thank you for viewing my video, and please subscribe or leave a comment down below. Thank you so much.